So first of all, I would like to present a few slides on the unsolder group, and then we will go on to present all the ATA project. So Unsaldo STS is a merger of Unsaldo Signal and Unsaldo Transporti, an Italian company. And so we have been merged in 2006, and usually we were previously CSE Transport in France, and so we are provide high level technology solution for the transport, railway transportation, and so Unsaldo STS France, the company I work for, I've been working in this company for almost 20 years now. So it's located in Vesulis, and we are almost 350 employees at this venue, and we have also a production plant in Rayon. This is a corporate slide, of course, just for to look at all the group location in the States. We are there is also the USS Union Switch Company, which is now a part of the Unsaldo Group. So we have many locations around the world. So we are positioning in all the railway subsystems, and we try to do more and more full railway system with all the infrastructures. It is for the bigger bigger project. So, if you want to go now further in detail in the product, so the signaling is our main activities in Les Ulis. So this is the old way of doing signaling system in the railway operation. It was 100 years ago. Now today, we are providing new solutions and electronic based solutions. So we have different systems. We have different systems developed in the company. We have does it work? Okay, that kind of what we call the ATP. ATP is automatic train protection. Those systems are supposed to manage the train spacing, especially in the high-speed line. You can operate train and send a high-speed train at 300 kilometers per hour, just separated by a few minutes interval. So this spacing has to be checked in safety. And so this is the purpose of our system. So the ATP located on the wayside. And we have also an embedded computer in the train, so there is a specific communication between all the computers, and just to share the vital data. We also build some different trackside equipment and some supervision equipment. But those supervision equipment are not real time; they are not. in the focus of this presentation. And so real-time ADA is used mainly on all the embedded computer in the train and in the ground systems. So our business line, high speed, suburban, computer-based interlocking, planning, supervision, components, and so on. High-speed lines, yes. Different lines we have down in we have equipped in around the world. So especially all the TGV in France, a lot of project in China too. So in UK, the train from from Paris to London, and everything is operated by Unsaldo computer. So the project, ADA project history. Yeah. So the ADA language was adopted at the end of the 80s for the first computerized ATP. So that was At this time, that was the reuse of a technique, encoded software technique, which was an already used technique by the CSM system. And it was developed. This technique was developed in a modular environment. So at this time, we define a subset of ADA. We use a subset of ADA to do a transam, a tool which converts the ADA to the modular, and to implement to reuse the system, the CSM technology, to do some encoded software technique. So that was the first implementation of ADA in the company. So with this first definition of a biprocessor architecture with a coded uniprocessor technology, we were able to build the first TVM 430, which is it was the first system operating on the northern line in Paris, Paris-Lille. As an improvement of the previous generation of ATP, which was a full analogical and digital hardware technology. So all the previous TGV in France from the Lyon, Paris-Lyon, and was operated in Paris, Paris-Nantes also, was operated with this TVM 300. So the first that was the first ADA project, real-time embedded project. So the ADA language was used to produce all the code. At that time, it was running on 68,000 and 6820 cards in the onboard equipment and on the ground system. Then the application tended to grow, and we have to do another computer, safety computer. To improve the performance, the limitation of the previous one, so we designed a new calculator to fit with the hot redundancy requirements for a new interlocking. So the interlocking is a system where a railway system which manage all the train routes. So you manage all the points, position, the itinerary. So you have to memorize all the position of everything in safety, in order to be sure that there's no problem and everything has to be consistent. And so this safety computer was developed with was also reusing a part of the previous technology, the uniprocessor technology, but in a new way. We are going to explain a little further. And so that was the first generation of the CSD. That was all done in the 68K technology, and the second generation was migrated on the CSD PowerPC. So. And at this migration, we were using the ADA core product and all the cross compiler from with the VxWorks solution. So to sum up all those bunch of products, so this is a little diagram to see the evolution in the. From the safety computing through the last decades. So this is today we are using the available vital computer, what stands for the CSD in French, and this computer was reusing a few techniques like the biprocessor and the coded uniprocessor, and so this. This is a generation of the TVM 430, the first ATP, the lines parallel. And this is, by the 2000s, this is the lines, the Mediterranean lines, Paris, Lyon to Marseille. And it was the first commercial use of this computing system. And now we have computing, this available vital computer is used also in the embedded architecture. We are going to see that a little further. So the project, the high-speed signaling systems, Lyon-Marseille, in high-speed line in China, the high-speed line in South Korea, the Seoul-Busan line, and then the last project, all the ERTMS project family, what we call the RBC, Radio Block Center. We also have a few projects in this from this type with a high-level signaling and with all the radio the radio transmission between the ground and on the trains. So on a on this map, you can see the different the different lines equipped with the system. So we are from London up to Paris, down to Lyon, down to Marseille, and then this one is not open Madrid-Lérida, but there is a junction which is supposed to open soon. And then from Barcelona to Madrid, all those lines are equipped with SCE or TVM equipment. So the equipment is based on different industrial racks dispatched along the track. So you have a different equipment here. Each equipment has a few control 15 kilometers between 15 and 30 kilometers of the track, and has to communicate to switch data from each computer and to follow the trains from all the line. And so it looks like industrial racks for the ground. So the ground systems. So let's go a little deeper in the structure of the CSD. So the CSD is a common core architecture. It implements different safety principles. It's a 2 out of 3 architecture. This kind of architecture was widely used in the kind of in aeronautics, for example, for hot redundancy purposes. So we are going to see some principles. So the safety is ensured by different mechanisms of dynamic information encoding, dynamic hardware self-test, dynamic consistency checks and context memory settings, temporal consistency, different consistency information outputs. We have also the availability with a lot of redundancy in the I/O channels, the hot control resuming, application transparent, so we can switch every board of the system without disturbing the two other channels. The adaptability, modularity towards inputs, outputs, and compatibility with any sequential software application. So this is important to stay in the real time and safety scope, and that the software which runs on those platforms are fully sequential, and that allow us to have a certification process without. A lot of issues on the scheduling. So the configuration, the high availability configuration, is made by this kind of architecture. We have three application blocks, two checkers, and two couplers in French to output all the message. And the three applications are computing the data in three different ways, and the results are compared dynamically by the two checkers for purpose of redundancy, and the output is controlled in safety by an energy controller, so we can switch off the output at any moment. So this is the hardware diagram. So it's based on the first architecture was based on the VME bus, three buses with different boards, and with the application board, the boards are containing the application software are here. So this software is a different at each project. Each project have its own software running on those boards, and all those boards contain the same software. The checker is a safety software which doesn't change, which remains the same all along the product lines. And those boards are data memory boards to exchange the data in real time. So it provides data mirroring in all the three buses. So each computer can access to a part of the context of the each other. So we can build a hot redundancy based on this on those devices. The architecture is a very classical thing. We have the hardware. We have an RTOS at the RTOS is not part. It can be it's a vague word, but it used to be ARTK in the previous implementation with the ALSYS environment system, and around this. Around the kernel, there is ADA runtime for the GNAT ADA, and around we have what we call the CSD software. CSD software is the first layer which computes all the the redundancy and which manage all the safety part of the core system. And then above this software, we can have the application software, which is specific to each project. And so this one does not change. It remains on all the platforms. So this example is this slide is done for the VxWorks, but we have exactly the same diagram for all the system we have made. So the roadmap of the CSD to see the progression in the history of the system. So the first CSD was released in the early just before the yes 1999 for the just before the opening of the Paris-Marseille LGV line. So that was the first platform, and from this platform we built different project, different other variation of this CSD, but very, very slight modification. We'll see the figures later concerning the line of code. So during the years, the platform then it crossed from a 6840 to the PowerPC over there, and to also ColdFire platform for the embedded platform, the onboard CSD version. So, on those slides, you can see clearly the three generation of products. So the first one was built all with ADA using the ANX 68K environment. This one using the GNAT VxWorks PowerPC, and this one the ADA GreenHill system. So we use all the major suppliers on the marketplace. So on the first generation, all the development were made on a VAX VMS platform with the DEC ADA compiler. So that was in the 1980s, and the parameter tool written in SQL ADA was also a big host tool to generate a part of the code, all the code related to the signaling parameters. So this tool was used to convert signaling diagram with all the name of the points, all the name of the routes, which is very specific for the signaling railway system, to convert all those data to a code and to a logical equation from to be used by the program. So in fact, this tool is it's a kind of a generator because it generates a full other sources which can be used by the compiler then by the application. And at that time we were using a cross compiler, the VAX VMS compiler from the L6. We are also using for the simulating the native compiler from L6 to on the first PCs. And with those tools, we are building a custom validation, and we are also using the Logiscope AIDA for the first safety activities and for the first coverage analysis and so on. The second generation of tool, it was on the Unix workstation, HP Hewlett-Packard workstation. It was also an L6 compiler with a RTK runtime. The testing tools were actual coverage, and with the ADA world also used on the L6 from the L6 supplier. So it was the first Windows compiler. And we also tried at the end of the 90s. We tried the code generator scale. It was a prototype Lustre to ADA. And it was first developed, it was the ancestor of the SCADE, SCADE tool, which is very famous today. And one of the prototypes was first to generate ADA code. And we have used on some prototype project, but it has never been released on a commercial base. So maybe STRL still have this project in his wallet, I suppose, or in his... maybe they will have it sometime on the market, but I think the C SCADE generator has a lot of success. So I'm not sure it's commercially sustainable for them. But okay, it's just for the story. So in 2000, the third generation of tools, it was ADA Core GNAT Pro, so the native and the cross compiler for the PowerPC. The Green Hill ADA Multi for the Coalfire, and the unit testing tool RTRC, and also Polyspace. So Polyspace we used the Polyspace at this time, but it, in fact it was quite complicated to put in place and to analyze for all the legacy code. It was not easy to analyze all the errors and all the false positives errors. So the Polyspace is not used anymore. I think it was it would have been a good tool, but it in fact is very difficult to use in a practical way. So some project based on different kind of platform. You can see all the lines also, Madrid, the Madrid Lerida, the Spain, the RBC on the Eastern line, some RATP, for example, from the subway in Paris. We have built some computers from our Ouragan project based on the CSD. And for the SIGLOC, it's an interlocking system for the SNCF. So the project line is still living. Safety activities. So this is a very classical scheme. all the safety the safety department is organized. Is organized to follow the development the V-cycle development. With all the different steps and all the different, we can see that on the diagram, the safety analyses are bigger than the development, the branch. And it's sometimes on some projects, it's the reality that the safety analysis takes more people than the development. with a huge application. So it's a big activity. So in our CSD, we have different kind of software, safety critical software. We are complying to the EN 500, the 50128 requirement from the which is a classification from the SEAL 0 to SEAL 4, different level of classification. And depending on this classification, we have a different method, all the code peer review, the code proofread, the test effort, test coverage, all the traceability. So it's very classical, but it's a huge effort to maintain all the traceability between all those all these phases. So the safety department are performing a lot of different kind of analysis to produce all the reports, the file for the assessment process. And at the end, we are able to certify the different platforms with all these validation artifacts. Inside this the EN 50128, for example, the new PowerPC platform has been qualified with proven in use. I know that a lot of certificators don't like the proven in use aspect, but this is a fact. And this platform, we are above this platform. We are using different kinds of tools. We are also using the sketch generators to build part of the applications. For the last application we have developed. We are using different kinds of techniques. The final certification was conducted by independent assessment companies like Certifair, Veritas, and for the certification project, we used a lot of legacy code, so for an heritage for the previous CSD platform. So at the first platform was approved with when the requirement was not existing. So it was a good way to argue with the assessment committee. And existing operational platform, the reuse of existing host and target test plan, and VxWorks have been taken as an industry de facto standard, just to avoid to use a certified version of VxWorks. So you have to keep in mind that we are not operating exactly the same mission critical level than the aeronautics, because we don't have to ensure all the if one of our computer crash or do some all the safety energy is shut down automatically by construction, so the train stops automatically. So it's not exactly the same field of mission critical than in aeronautics. So this is to explain. Maybe we can sometimes have some arrangement with the requirements, the certification requirements. So for the new constraints have been added in the CSD development, dynamic collaboration disabled at runtime, internal ADA coding rules by the automatic verification tools with ADA control tools from Jean-Pierre Rosen, different the KPR analysis, the known problem analysis also performed by Jean-Pierre. So it enables us to qualify the CSD platform without using the VxWorks cert on the GNAT Pro integrity. But strictly speaking, we if we build a new calculator from scratch and to comply with the SEAL 4 standards, we should have something maybe to use with high integrity, and we should have used some high integrity tools. So some project figures to have some elements in mind. So just to see the evolutions of those developments. So the first safety computer, the TVM 430, it was only 3,000 kilo line of code. It is effective line of code, and so without it's real line of code. So 3,000 kilo line of code. So it's not not 3,000 line. Yes, with 30,000 line of code. Yes. So it was quite simple and really simple to integrate and to prove. So at this time we are sticking to the KISS principle, the keep it simple and stupid. So that was the principle adopted at this time. And then after the few generation, it started to grow. So the basic the two figures here. So we have 80,000 lines of code for the CSD, for the core part of the CSD, and 32, this is an application. So the first application was almost of the same size of the previous ATP. And only the only difference was made by the, we have made a generic core, the CSD generic core. And then for the different platforms, you can see some evolution, some for the application in the beginning of the 2001, for the CSD, the Spanish CSD application, the interlocking from the ISP line in Spain, the application has grown from 100,000 lines of code, and for the RBC, the radio block control center, the application is about 300 lines, 300,000 lines of code. And the same for the onboard. So the RBC is on board, on ground, and the EVC is the same on board, and it's almost the same complexity. And for the last generation of application we are building, so it's a new generation of interlocking, but it includes all the more and more control to more and more line to control. So with that kind of with the generation of application, you can control in safety maybe 100 kilometers of line. So it is as if it includes several of these elementary system. So the complexity is now about 400,000 line of code. And the last level, the most complex application is the zone controller for the subway, and it's about 6,000 lines of code of ADA code, 600,000 lines of code, plus all the C code, which is about 200,000 lines generated by the SCADE tools. This generation, we use on those two products, they also use a C-scale generator. So it makes a huge difference. We have increased the complexity by a ratio of 20 between the 1980s and the 2010s. And so with this ratio, it's no more KISS principle. It's more blood, sweat, and tears sometimes. So figure also for the configuration management. So the SE interlocking project is about three. For example, it's a project for one line. It's 30 equipments in the signaling rooms around along the tracks. So it makes 90 different executable object files to deploy on the field. And so each line, you have something like 90 to 200 different executable files to manage. So at the end, it's more than 500 executable files in the world. So to keep in track in the software configuration management. So because for maintenance purpose, we have to ensure everything about each executable file. So it makes a huge effort of management software configuration management, and that's one of the biggest issues we are facing today. This is yes, two legacies. You have legacy through the years and legacy through the layers. The first one is legacy codes maintenance for the long-lasting railways products. The product life is 15 to 20 years and even more. So we have to maintain to maintain all the software tools, the compilers, the host machines. For example, for the first generation of our system in the VAX VMS. So we are still able to produce and to recompile the application at the exact point that they were in the 90s. So we have a full VAX VMS machine, which is now emulated. It's now it's a virtualization from the Sharon system. It is hosted on the Intel platform, and it's a full emulation of a digital system. It lacks exactly like the VAX VMS system, and it runs the LCS compiler as it was with the same compiler. All the software configuration tools, they run exactly the same way. Yes. So this is one dimension of the problem, and the other dimension is the vertical dimension, legacy through the layers, through the layer of code, and we are accumulating so many software that we have the problem of managing the training, the know-how, and so we're facing sometimes reuse or refactoring for a new project, because at the end we have too many layers of code. So the perspective, and this is to end the systematic use of qualified automatic codes. So this is the trend today, like a SCAD. All the test coverage issues from the native and the target codes consistency. So the host testing on the final target code, this is a very interesting track with the virtualization approach of the QEMU, the GNATPro project coverage. So I think in our scope, it is those two things are very interesting. The improvements. It would be on the general certification process, because we are leaving a lot of energy in the certification process. So you have to take into account at the very beginning of the development process, and to use the qualified tool for the code generators, the checkers, the code review. It could spare a lot of time during the assessment process. So this is the object of, for example, Project Adacor Ally project, and to manage all this complexity of all the artifacts for the assessment process. So final some references, different. if you can refer to those, if you want to learn more about the ADA safety layers we use at the beginning of the story, and different article of Jean-Louis Boulanger, for example, who describes a lot of this architecture in the literature. There is a title in English, Safety Computer Architecture. In this book, you will have some details about on the CSD, on the different kind of architecture, the principles, the theoretical principles of those computers. So that's it, and thank you for your attention.